يا ويحهم ماذا جنوا وتأفكوا وأتوا بقول الجاهل الفتان. ورأيت منهم أرعنا يدعو إلى سحر يحل به لدى الكهان. ورأيت منهم تافها يدعو إلى حل المعازف والغنى الشيطان.
الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, today my subject is why do a lot of children see the shaitan jinn at a very young age? You see, you have to know your enemy. The enemy shaitan jinn, you have to know his ways, his game, all you have to know. And when he comes to the children at this very young age, it's the responsibility of the parent. Because the parent, when they become parent, it's a blessing from Allah Rabbul Izzah, and they need to give that child a proper education and a proper security. If the parents neglect this, they don't give the child proper security and proper education, the child will start having problems at a very young age. And what happened then is the parents, they start looking for solutions, while the solution was already there before the problem began. It's by following the Quran and the Sunnah. All you who Muslims, follow the Quran, the Sunnah, you'll be saved. Around the world today, there is a big percentage of children spotting the shaitan jinn. Now, my main subject is, why do children see the shaitan jinn? What is the name of this jinn? And what are the reasons? What is his name? His name is Arwah. This jinn is very dangerous. Arwah jinn appears to the child as an old woman, old man, and resembles the grandfather or the grandmother, or as appear to the child, a young girl with blood on her body or young boy. And she start taunting, or he start taunts the child, and the child will develop fear. The battle, that is where it starts, when the child starting to develop fear and he's scared. What's the reasons of this jinn appearing to the children? It's four reasons. Reason number one is when the environment of the house is music, pictures everywhere, this jinn will appear because it's not Islamic environment. Reason number two is when the house is haunted. But this one, I will rule it out. Why do I rule it out? Because if the family is upon the Quran and the Sunnah, there is no way the house will be haunted and the jinn will come and dwell in the house. Unless the family has been hit by evil eye, or the child has been hit by evil eye, or magic. So reason number three, either evil eye, or reason number four, magic. So when the family has magic and evil eye, then this jinn will come and taunt the child. If the child also has evil eye, he will come and start saying, I need to be your friend, or I am your friend. And slowly, slowly, the friendship will develop, or the child will soon having changes in him slowly by slowly. Let me pause for a bit and explain a story. A story of a friend of mine. Is a sheikh, called me a couple of weeks, let's say a month ago. He called me and he said, "Ya sheikh, my son, he's about 10 years old now. He's not well. When he sleeps, he screams. He's doing erratic things which is not normal." I told him what happened. He started explaining, when he was 2 years old, the child used to see a young girl come to the house and she plays far away from him. She plays for the whole day, and the evening when he approaches, the father comes and take the child and goes. Now, this child used to explain to the father and the mother. But what happened is the father and the mother ignored and neglected that child. They did not pay attention. I told him, "Ya Sheikh, it is too late." But also, it's not too late because the child is still young. When your child starts explaining to you, "I have an imaginary friend," or "I see somebody," he explained to you anything to do with the entity. These stories are real. Know that it is arwah jinn, and your decision should not be based on emotion. Your decision should not be rational thoughts. Your decision should be based upon the text, how to eradicate this problem. As arwah jinn is dangerous, he will make friendship with a child and he will end up possessing, and he will make it difficult for the child when the child is grown up. He can turn up to become an ashiq jinn. Allah knows best. Now, what are the signs where this arwah jinn appears to the child frequently? Now, if the child have these signs, know that arwah is visiting him and you need as soon as possible to take actions. Sign number one is the child will tell you, I have seen a dark figure coming out from the closet with horns, or coming out from the corner of the house or the corner of the door. You should be worried. Sign number two is the child will wake up in the dream screaming he has seen somebody. Sign number three is the child will feel someone is tickling him and waking him up in the dream and he doesn't see anything. The child will be afraid in a specific place in the house. The child will develop fear to walk around alone in the house. The child will lose appetite totally, or he will have a very high appetite of eating a lot. You'll wonder, is it normal for him to be like this? The child would be saying to you, my bed shakes every night. The child would be scared of dark night. He would be scared. He wants his room always the light on when he goes in his room. The child would be sleepwalking in the night. The child will tell you, I have seen an ugly woman or ugly man, old, or I have seen a child, a girl who is full of blood, or she's ugly, or a boy. This is when the arwah jinn is visiting your child. So you should be worried. And you should take a rational decision which are based upon the text. Straight away through the treatment. Now, how to treat oneself is, if the house is upon filth, music, and all dirty stuff, it needs to be eradicated. And salah 5 times. Adhkar morning, evening. Dua ilallah, isti'ana ilallah. And read on the room of the child, in the corners of the child. The child room, read Ayatul Kursi. And get olive oil and water. Read on it, on the olive oil. Apply on the child morning, evening. And the water, make him drink. What to read? Read Ayatul Kursi, قُلْ أَذْبِرَ الْفَلَقُ قُلْ أَذْبِرَ النَّاسِ قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. And if you want to go one more step farther, you can install infrared CCTV camera. It's very important to do this today because the technology is there. It's very, very important. And do every time when the child is asleep, read on him for at least minimum of half an hour. Read before it's too late. وآخر دعوانا وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.